The same way, you can even rename your table names. Now it's called as table alias. Assume that you have a lot of tables in your query. Now in our upcoming sessions, I think I'll be talking about Oracle joins. Now in joins, you will be using multiple tables to join. So in one single query, you might have more than two tables. In that case, or in that scenario, it becomes so hard to write down all the table names than the column names and the column names. So I know at this stage, I want to keep it simple. Once we are in joins, I'll come back to this table aliasing concept once again. So what you can do is, like in this query, so let me first write a query for you guys. Select last underscore name, comma, salary, comma. Okay, we'll just query these two from hr.employees. So we are querying only these two columns. Perfect, we have the output. When we work with joins, there are multiple tables from table employee and table department. Now in this case, the query does not know whether the last name belongs to employee table or department table. In this case, what we do is we assign alias to the table name. After the table name, you just specify any of your alias name for the table. For example, like EMP. Now in this case, what happens is, for your query, what you can say is select emp.lastname and select emp.salary. So this way, in your query, what happens is the SQL will get to know that this last name column has to be taken from employee table, and this salary also has to be taken from employee table. So this table alias right now in a simple query, it does not make sense. But when we are working in Oracle joins or the SQL joins, then you will understand the power of table aliasing. So in a table alias, what we do is we can assign a simple term or simple name or simple identification to a table, and then for all the column names that we want to query from a specific table, we can use the table alias before the column names. All right. So in a very simple query, it does not make any sense to use table alias, but in joins, table alias will be very helpful because it helps you to identify from which table you are querying which column.